mama, don't stress your mind. We coming home tonight. Hey mama, we're gonna be your... Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. I hope you all are in a good situation. Welcome back to my video. I'm Siti Ramawati. Well, related to the previous video, it's about teaching English with multimedia in rural area. In this opportunity, in this video, I'm going to share you the information about teaching English with multimedia by using CLT. So let me show you what we are going to know. First, I'm going to talk to you about what CLT is, then what multimedia is. After that, what does teaching English with multimedia by using CLT mean? And the last, I will talk about the stages in teaching English. So check it out. Well, first is Communication Language Teaching, or CLT. So, CLT is an approach in teaching the language to the students. CLT can be understood as a set of principles about the goals of language teaching, how learners learn the language, the kinds of classroom activities in teaching language, and then the roles of teachers and learners in the classroom. So, for your information, the goals of language teaching are to become communicatively competent, and then to use the language appropriate for a given social context, and also to manage the process of relating meaning with interlocutors. So, how learners learn the language? Actually, CLT uses almost any activity that engages learners in authentic communication. Functional communication activities in which communication is involved, and social interaction activities such as conversation and discussion session, dialogue and role plays. So what kinds of classroom activities, it also depends on the student's need. So the teacher is their roles as the facilitator should be able to know what kind of classroom activities that is suitable for their students. There are many examples of kind of activities that can be used, such as role play, language games, picture strip story, and mini drama. So, related to the roles of teachers and learners in the classroom, so if the teacher as the facilitators, the learners here is the learners are as the communicators. They are actively engaged in trying to make themselves understood and in understanding others. So it is what we called the student-centered take apart. So the students or the learners more actively in this area. It also related to the goals of language teaching, to become the communicatively competent, and the students can use the language appropriate for a given social context. Well, the next is multimedia. According to our topic, teaching English with multimedia, so we should know what multimedia is. Multimedia can be defined as the integration of multiple media elements such as audio, video, graphics, text, animation into one synergetic. So, we can say that multimedia is we use more than one media into one synergetic. So, in teaching English, we can use multimedia as the tools or the materials that can support the teaching and learning process.
So, what does teaching English with multimedia by using CLT mean? CLT enhances English skills such as reading and speaking through interactive tasks such as showing performance like drama, singing a song, or any kind of activities in CLT. Then, when teaching English by using CLT, here multimedia can support it. Multimedia as the authentic materials to the native speakers of the target language, such as radio, television, broadcast, games, electronic, and any kinds of multimedia can support in teaching English by using CLT. So, multimedia make the teaching English more easier.
Well, the last is the stages of teaching CLT. There are three stages of teaching CLT. The first is pre-communication stage, the second is quasi-communication stage, and the third is real communication stage.
The first stage is pre-communication, means you prepare before communication. As the teacher, we have preparation before the communication. Not only the teacher, but also the students. Both teacher and students prepare before communication, such as the teachers ask the students to read, mean the students make preparation to read before communication. Then the teacher can give them some exercises about the language, then also give them brainstorming or discussion to establish the vocabulary and expression to be used to accomplish the communicative intent. Includes a framework or means of structuring a conversation or exchange to achieve the purpose of the speakers.
Well, the second stage is quasi-communication stage. Quasi means seemingly, apparently but not really. It means this communication stage is like real communication stage, but it is not real. It is like question and answer based on the dialogue topic and situation, like with question, yes or no question, or open-ended question. This is a role recognition and interpretative activities, including oral production proceeding from guided to freer communication activities. For example, the students are reading or copying of the dialogue with variations for reading and writing practice.
Well, the last is real communication stage. This is the purpose of teaching English. I mean teaching language, right? In this real communication stage, students are able to show their real communication in the real situation. They are able to create and show their language performance in the real situation. It is how the language target is approach. They can create, they can show by themselves.
I think that's all that I can deliver to you at this time. So, teaching English with multimedia by using CLT is a very important thing for me as the future teacher when we want to teach language. I'm so sorry for my mistakes. I hope this information can be useful for you.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.